Hello and welcome back, dear friends. It's me, Odo, and this is a new episode of our EU4 campaign with Ethiopia. I wasn't playing for quite some time now, and since the last time I played, I bought one new expansion, the Rights of Man expansion, for different reasons. It's also affecting our gameplay here very much because it's given new opportunities for Coptic nations, and we are Coptic as Ethiopia. As you can see, we have a new alert here and a new button down here. We can do blessings. The Coptic religion now has five religious centers, and with each center we get one blessing. We control two centers and they are also Coptic, but I believe we also get a blessing for the Coptic center in Yerevan because it's, well, it's Coptic. It's not controlled by us but by Armenia, and that's okay. As I have a new expansion, the game told me I'm not able to get any achievements anymore, but yeah, I really don't play because of the achievements. I will try to get the Prester John achievement, not to get it, but to have the to control the stuff I have to control for the Prester John, which would be to control also Alexandria, Antiochia, and Constantinople. Yeah, let's see if we can do that. We'll have to fight the Ottomans for that. But as I said before, we get some blessings and we control two centers, and I'm not sure if we can select now two or three blessings, and they are really nice. I mean, this one is especially nice for us, as it's really hard for us to convert the provinces to Coptic. I'll probably take this one first. We can take a second one, and the core creation cost is also nice. Manpower recovery would be also nice because we are always low on manpower. Not now at the moment, but we will be again, I fear. Yearly legitimacy is okay, but I'm not really sure if it's worth it. Discipline is also good as we fight better. But I think, as we are expanding fast, I'll take the core creation cost. This would have been better at the start of the game, probably. We could have saved tons of admin points. But yeah, let's take it now. And yeah, as I thought, we can also put a third. I think we don't have much problem with legitimacy, so I think the manpower recovery is the best, or the discipline. I really don't know. Discipline to fight better, or manpower to get more persons to fight. Yeah, anyway, let's take the manpower. Yeah, and the fourth we can't pick now. We'll try to get Alexandria as soon as possible. I'm not sure if it's possible with this DLC. I think I also took it because we can now make send missionaries to our subjects. I hope we can do that. I want to make Jerusalem Yeah, let's see. First of all, we will do not much in this this probably. I don't know, but probably we'll attack them. No, we can't. We have a truce with them. Ah, yeah, I know, because we freed them from Nerched. We have a holy war casus belli against probably everyone around us. But we also have a truce with probably everyone around us. Yeah. Yeah, truce. Truce. And I think we have a looming coalition. So also we don't want to pick up fights with them. They have a truce with nearly everyone but with us. But they are transferring trade power to us. Ah, they are our vessel. No. Gujarat was the one I was wanting. I wanted to look at. And we have a truce with them. Only 2 years more. But Sindh is not creating cores on Rajkot as I hoped they would do. Why don't we have a holy war casus belli against them? I mean, they are not, they are definitely not Coptic. We should get the holy war casus belli, but probably because we don't border them. And Sindh is probably not Coptic. We didn't transfer them to Coptic. Anyway, I think we should do some war here in India. It's really rich country, and we probably could integrate Fars as we will have Dawasir to take over this land for us. Dawasir has some cores here also in Najd, and we didn't conquer the whole of the Mamluk country because we wanted also money or more money out of them. Yeah, that's our options. By the bank of the Nile, glory to the Lord Khazr Ibrim is ours. This is probably a event that we got through this DLC that I bought. For many years, this great Christian city has preserved even though surrounded by religious enemies. Ah, Copts in the Lower Nubia area are coming out of hiding, gain 10 prestige. Ah, that's nice. The Holy Heart of Ethiopia. Once Axum was the heart of the ancient Axumite Empire, bastion of Christian power, situated at the crossroads of Africa, Arabia and the Greco-Roman world. Yeah, that's our more or less capital. Among the obelisks and palace ruins we have rebuilt the churches of this mighty nation of old. The greatest of them all is the Church of Our Lady Mary of Zion. It is the place where we crown our emperors, the descendants of Menelik the First, who was the son of King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba. It is here he brought the Ark of the Covenant. Every year, thousands of pilgrims come from the farthest reaches of our empire and beyond to visit this holy place. Once more, Axum will shine with God's infinite glory. That's probably events that we get when we liberate one of the holy sites and make it Coptic, like Iskandera or Alexandria. But I really don't know if we are able to defeat the Ottomans. As I said before, they are quite a problem for us. Look how fast they've grown. They've grown even faster than us now that the Mamluks are gone. But as we have the Austrians as allies, they probably won't attack us. Let's see. Let's see. The heart of Armenia, Yerevan, has been liberated by our fellow yeah. That's the same event as ours for the Armenians. They get some prestige that they that Yerevan is Coptic. We could try to ally Armenia as well. Nah, probably not. Should we? Now we could get rid of the Karakoyunlu alliance. I mean, they are really, really losing every war they are doing. They once owned this whole land, and now they are down to just these measly seven, six provinces, two, four, six, seven provinces, and they lose the war against Najd also. Oh. I mean, I really would like to help them against Najd, but ah, no, there are two regions as well. Probably they are winning their war because Najd was crushed by us. Yeah, anyway. It appears David I is now calm. Ah, this is one of the things that we got also with this. This is, I believe, one of the reasons I wanted to take it, because our rulers now have traits. Calm is really stupid. Reduces the stability cost, but we don't need that. And we get the second now. And the third we get only after 25 years of ruling. So we'll get probably soon the second trait. Conflicts and protests over taxes, blah 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 blah. What? What? 572 ducats. Yeah, but the burghers will get loyal. And we don't lose stability. Okay. Let's take another loan. Oh my god, we have so many loans now. Nah, don't take loans. Conversion successful. Okay. How many loans? Oh, just one. No, it's two now. So we can convert something more. It's so expensive. Sure, there is another conversion button here. Where is it? There. Now we can't convert our allies' lands. Our hummus takes 50 ducats per month. That's incredibly stupid. A stupid lot. It's much too expensive. It's much too expensive to do all these missionary stuff. Oh. That's not nice. Sena will be converted by me now. Let's see. Sena or Minabe? Nah, not Minabe. It's 23 ducats. Where is Minabe? Anyway. There is Minabe. Do we have already the edict on? It takes us, but it gets us 1.5% of unity, but it costs 240 ducats. I can't afford that. Sina, where is Sina? Here is Sina. But Lower Zambezi is not a state, so we can't do the edict there. But anyway, I mean, it's 40 ducats and it's 0.5. We'll probably have to take the religious idea group as well. So, stop. He also got to be an entrepreneur. Ah, we get 10% trade efficiency. That's okay. And we took a loan. Yeah, that's not okay, but okay. What can we do? Spy network in Afghanistan. We don't need any spy network there then. So where do we want to get a claim? Probably the capital, Kabul. It's a really highly developed land for Afghanistan, but probably better Kunduz to get the adjacency to Transoxiana. Yeah, but we can take Kunduz in the next war anyway, so let's take the claim on Kabul. And it's cheaper to core it after we've taken it. How about the war against them? We don't have... Why don't we have a CP against them? Doesn't Fars have a CP against them? We really don't have any money. That's not good. We really need money. Ah, but we rooted out corruption nearly, so it will be positive soon, hopefully. Hopefully it will be positive soon. And we also get more money now from trade because of the now new trade of our leader. We've gained a conquest casus belli. Yeah. Ah, stop. We need to do something with our diplomats. Let's send one of the diplomats. To allies. Oh, we can that's a new thing also. We are now a great power. We're really a great power. We're in second place. We can now influence nations. Whatever influence nation is. I believe it's something of getting a better... getting them better to like us or something like that. But we have no diplomats to send, so we can influence nations with all these. Why can we do that, and what does it do? Like, how about this country? We can offer an alliance. They are threatened by us. Why are they threatened by us? Can we declare war? Do I have a casus belli on them? No. Then why are they threatened by us? Don't understand. But can we now? Ooh, great power actions. Take on foreign debt. They have no debt. Influence nation, we'll influence them towards our viewpoint. Intervene in war. Ooh, break alliance. We'll demand that they break one of their alliances. Fancy. We could intervene in their war. And in their war. We'll help them out in their war against our competing great powers. Will we attack Najd if we intervene in this war? I really don't know. Ah. Then the Ottomans will come into this war probably. Won't they? They are not at war with the Ottomans now. If we intervene in war with them, okay, yeah, I don't understand what this does. It doesn't matter. We have some plus money. Why is that? Because we rooted out corruption, nearly. Yay. We are making money again. So let's put our army a bit up, not too much. We have much too many ships, but we don't have too many troops. Yeah, that's okay. Probably the ships are the problem now. So we need coastal provinces to support more ships. Yeah. I mean, you Gujarat. And you Sakalava. Can we attack them? No, not now. Only in 1597. But Gujarat will be able to attack in 1596, so that's good. We don't get any coastal provinces from Hedges anymore, so it's not even worth doing that. But there are coastal provinces of Hormuz that we can take. And we could try to integrate Fars now. Probably we should do that. How about our technology? I really don't know how far we are away. Diplomacy is really bad now. We are only on tech 11. We really need to. We really need to get some tech points. What's that? Royal marriage with Fars. Yeah, I accept. What's that? Karakuyumdu ask for military access. Ah. So the Ottomans attacked them. The Ottomans did what I wanted to do. Can we intervene? No, because we have a truce with Najd. Yeah, Karakuyumdu will be crushed again. That's not good for them. Yeah, they're still bigger than I thought. There's also land up here. So we want some more war goals, but I see I don't have any claims on the Ottomans, I see. We should get some claims on the Ottomans. So let's do some spy network. And also I'm not sure if this is the DLC where we get bonus for spy network in laying siege to their provinces. How about the devastation situation? It's good. We've got a lot of prosperity, especially also down there. That's good with the gold mines. Ah, gold mines. I forgot. I wanted to look how long till prosperity sets in here, because if they are prosperous, then we will try to do some clicks here as well. There are some prosperity issues. We have there this gold mine. And ah, yeah, they are not pissed off anymore. You really have to lower their influence a bit. It's way too high. It's rather risky to have it that high, I believe. Partially depleted. I shouldn't have looked at it. Why did this happen? Really? Do we have any edicts on there? No, it's there. There's no current. The Oromo. A strange nomadic people have crossed our border from the African interior into our borderlands, migrating in large numbers, protected by variable warriors. Their alien customs threaten to rip apart and reshape the very fabric of society here. No, migrants! These disciples of Vark are quickly displacing and converting the followers of the all faiths in the area, replacing old social structures with new ones of their own. What? Katrin Hadia will become Oromo. Changes to fetishist. What? you're not really doing that, aren't you? Are the after Ogaden, Davaro? No, don't tell me these are already Coptic lands. RZ? Nah! You are... Who scripted this event? This is... unacceptable. Ogaden, Davaro, Ogaden. Okay, Ogaden is okay because that's Sunni. Sidamo, where is Sidamo? There is nah. Hadija is also already Coptic. Come on. And we can't convert them back because they have a -8. And it's so expensive to... Although they have -8, we get a 2.4% chance of converting them. This is really stupid. Couldn't it be there in this land, like Gedo and stuff like that? Also, the culture's not ours anymore. Where's the cultures? There is the cultures. I mean, really? I thought also in Ogaden they went. Oh. At least they are Somali, so they are in my culture group. Nubian, Shona. We should transfer also Yemeni and Swahili, probably also, that it's easier to convert them. This is not nice. Oh, we now see a lot more land. We probably should try to get some land along this coast as well. I mean, we wanted to do some war with Gujarat, and we have a Afghanistan and Delhi, but they transfer trade power to us, so we can't attack them now. Why is it back? Why do we lose money again? Romo settlers, groups of nomadic settlers. Really? Even more in Sheva. And I believe Sheva is also one of the... Yeah, of course. Of course. It's Coptic. It was Coptic. Ugh. We could do Minabe. It's really expensive, but if we... If we do it, we get 1.5% unity. It's really good. Oh. 15 months in Mukala, Katiri. They are rather cheap in comparison to that. They take some more time, but they are 10 times cheaper. And if we do 10 of these provinces, it's much more religious unity than that. So yeah, this is some kind of so let's see, where's Mukala? It's here. Did we? Yeah, we did make. So let's do Mukala. Now even only 13 months, so it's even better. Mukala, Katiri and Shir will be done next. Subject countries like that. Why not? Yeah, that's good. And what did we say? Next, we'll take Katiri. Even less expensive than before. So we'll get some money now, and we'll probably be able to pay back some of our loans. But we should be ready to do some more war down here. How about Gujarat. When does our truce end? 1596 in November, so 1.5 years. We've got some time. But we'll probably take this guy down there. Yeah. Yeah. Of course. Died. Trade efficiency, diplomatic reputation, or one of these. Let's see if we can get some more. These are from the burgers. Don't they come from there? Nah. We can't get any. Level 3 theologian. Take the level 2 guy, but morale of navies is really not interesting. The diplomatic reputation reputation is nice because everyone likes us more. The trade efficiency is nice because we got more money. I really don't know which is better of these two. Who's the older one? He's older. Yeah. Oh, let's take him. I think more money is good. Plus 536 and trade is 27.11. How much does he increase that? 28.47. So he's paying himself in this trade income stuff. Yeah, that's good. So we have some transport navy. Transports, come here. Fetch some troops. We probably should go here. Or here. Don't have to be on the ships too long, and we probably Isfahan declared war on Afghanistan. That's good, because if we declare then war on Gujarat, Afghanistan won't come for the help of them. Although it's okay, I mean, I would do a war with Afghanistan. It's really not the problem anymore. There is only this one region with a four, and I mean, it's really no magic for us. The only problem in this war will be probably Delhi, but I really don't know if they even get to us. It will be much less problematic than the last war we did with Gujarat. So I want to know. Supply limit. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, they can move there. That's good. So, but we will do this only next time. Until then, I wish you a nice and pleasant evening. I hope you enjoyed it. We will see each other again. Bye.